right? If I draw a graph, I already told you the depletion layer is there. It is a P region and it is a N region. If we connect in forward bias, P connected to plus terminal and N connected to negative terminal, right? Now this PN, at the time we have a depletion layer is there. What is the depletion layer width? Depletion layer width around 0.6 volts. Before, below the 0.6 volts, if you apply the voltage here, below the 0.6 volts, this voltage not changes anything. That's why here I'm applying the voltage. Here 0.2, if you apply, there is no change. Current not passes, current zero. Here current zero. Even though you apply 0.2 volts, current zero. 0.4 volts, current zero. Why? We have to apply more than 0.6. Yes, up to 0.6, current zero. Current is zero in forward bias up to 0.6. After 0.6, current increases like this. Current increases rapidly. Why current increases, sir? Because depletion layer width decreases. Depletion layer width decreases, automatically current increases. See, current increases, current is more. Where you are getting more current? See, a potential at which you are getting more current, that potential is called as threshold potential. Threshold potential. What is threshold potential? In forward bias, at which potential current is increases, that potential name is a threshold potential. It has another name. What is another name, sir? That is also called as knee potential. It has one more name also. What is that name? That name is cut in potential. Threshold potential or knee potential or cut in potential, all are same. What is the definition of threshold potential or knee potential or cut in potential? The potential at which current increases rapidly. See, if you apply 0.2 here, 0.2, there is no current. That's why the 0.2 is not a threshold. At 0.4, no current. At 0.6, yes, I have a current. That's why that 0.6 is called as a threshold potential. That is in forward bias. Now come to reverse bias. In reverse bias, current is very, very less. See, it's a very, very less. In microamps, current is very, very less. After, current is increases rapidly. We will get a doubt here. In forward bias, current is more. That's why we are getting a graph like that. In reverse bias, current is less. We have to get this line only. After particular potential, current increases. In reverse bias also, we get more current. The particular potential at which current is more. This potential, we are getting more current. A particular potential at which we are getting more current. That potential name is a breakdown potential. That potential name is a breakdown potential. What is the threshold what is threshold potential? A potential at which we get more current, that is called as a threshold potential in forward bias. What is breakdown potential? In reverse bias also we get more current. A potential at which we get more current, that is called as a breakdown potential. See, we get a line here, current line. It is a less current. This current has a name. This current name is saturation, reverse saturation current. Reverse saturation current. In reverse bias, we get a small amount of current. This small amount of current is a reverse saturation current. This reverse saturation current, what happening, sir? This reverse saturation current increases. We will get a doubt. In reverse bias, how current increases? What happening there? That is wrong now. What is wrong? Why that is wrong? Because in reverse bias, depletion layer width is more. I already told you. If depletion layer width is more, we get a less current. But here I am telling we get more current also. What happening, sir? We have to discuss that using the breakdown potential. So in reverse bias, we are getting more current. Check this diagram again. In reverse bias, we are getting more current because of the breakdown. In reverse bias, we have two breakdowns. In reverse bias, we have two breakdowns. One is a avalanche breakdown. Next one is a zener breakdown.